Here it comes, fans, and this should be absolutely insane. Here he is, ultra-violent Concession Boy.
Concession Boy, the master of the IPW exclusive Bratwurst, challenging for the IPW Hardcore title. Kubiak, back in his size as the Snack Pack Kubiak, complete with Hostess Tees and other snack-like variety cakes.
I tell you what, back in his Snack Pack rooms, he told me it was for one night only, but the fans sharing it up, so I'm not sure if he's going to be able to stick to that. And Concession Boy knows just to stay out of the ring for right now. He's going to be in there with this monster Kubiak soon enough. Soon enough.
Former member of the Snack Pack, current IPW Hardcore Champion, the former leader of the Snack Pack, the original Dudley Dudley, going on to his second tour of Big Japan Pro Wrestling, August 8th. He's going back for the Harder Than Hardcore Tour. August 8th, 3 weeks of death matches. Dudley Dudley, when he gets back to IPW, Kubiak has made it clear he wants a match. He wants to defend his title against his former mentor.
And that's going to be one hell of a match when it happens. And Concession Boy taking it right to Kubiak, a drop toe hold, followed by some elbows and some fists to the head. And Concession Boy's wrestling in the hardcore match, and he doesn't even normally wrestle in his wrestling matches.
Concession Boy has made it clear. He may be one of the comedy fixtures here in IPW. He might be one of the favorites of the fans when they want to go over and buy it. Oh my God, what is he even thinking? Smashing Kubiak in the head. Obviously he's not thinking. He wanted to be taken seriously and gets hit right upside the head with a frying pan, which last week I seen him making some hash browns in and selling for 2 for 79 cents.
Yeah, Concession Boy pulling double duty. He's being ultra violent and hardcore. As long as his regular duties behind the concession stand, everybody here at IPW, or IPW,
OPW,
whatever, multi-talented.
And he's led to the ring by the not-so-multi-talented Lucius Sweets, who is at ringside in awe, scared to death, saying, Kubiak, please don't hit me in the head with anything that you're waffling Concession Boy with. Concession Boy looks like a cross between Donatello from the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles and Bruce Lee.
Well, I'm not quite sure about that analogy, but one thing he does look like is he's already in a little bit of pain. And Kubiak, what is that, lemon juice?
Lemon juice spit into the eyes of Concession Boy. Oh my God, and he pours it right over his head. And when you have an open, gaping wound in your skull or cranium, there is nothing worse than lemon juice poured over your head. My grandpappy told me so, Aaron.
Your grandpappy was a wise one, Ron Nemi, and he's still trying to hit Kubiak over the head. And Kubiak's going, why does he keep doing this?
Kubiak says, that doesn't hurt me. As a matter of fact, it tickles my fancy. That's right, it tickles my fancy.
And the lemon juice still in the eyes of Concession Boy, and so were those thongs right there. Right, not thongs, I'm too used to those dancing girls being out here. Thongs, I should say. And he's just taking it right to the head of Concession Boy. And Concession Boy was showing himself very, very well in his first title match. But if Kubiak keeps up like this, keeps toying with him, Concession Boy may not want to get back in the ring.
Straight Call Star Stevens, a.k.a. the Mud Baby Star Stevens, is the only referee that wanted to call this match. He's the only man that wants to get in the ring with the incredibly violent Kubiak.
Incredibly.
Incredibly. That's even more worse than incredibly.
I tell you what, Kubiak, looking around like the crazed monster he is, he wants something else to punish Concession Boy with, and he's found it.
Concession Boy busted wide open, and you thought that was bad. Now he has cocoa puffs dumped over his head. For God's sake, what's next? Frankenberry?
Frankenberry has been off the shelves, or he would have already bought it.
Oh.
What in the world was that?
That was supposed to be a powerbomb, but his head is so slippery from the application of lemon juice and the cocoa's puffs that he slipped out and was lucky to not end up with a broken neck at the hands of Kubiak.
I tell you what, at least he did slip out, because else he would have taken that.
He tried on the Kubi bomb into an ample portion of cocoa puffs.
And this match could not get any more violent, I don't think, Ron Nemi.
That's unless they break out the sweet honey grahams, or perhaps the apple jacks.
Or the crispy...
Forget it, Aaron, while you're lost. You're lost, you're tired, you're hot. We're at the WrestlePlex, it's blazing hot. We got a hardcore brawl. Concession Boy is breaking all the nut shots. It's the only thing he can do to get out of these breakfast cereal death matches.
I tell you what, Concession Boy, taking, like you said, the last thing he could do, his last resort, but now he's taking back over the match. And he's taking... What is that weapon? He's taking right to the head of Kubiak.
It looks like it might be them thongs, as you called them earlier. Maybe tongs, perhaps some corn on the cob skewers. All I know is it's sharp and it's deadly, and he's busting open the head of Kubiak.
There's a pizza cutter.
Oh, the pizza cutter, which he happens to be a master of. He has cut many slices of pizza for the hungry fans of IPW to devour at the shows at the WrestlePlex.
And next week at our show, August the 17th, Concession Boy will be selling slices of Kubiak's cranium for $1.50 a piece.
As a matter of fact, he'll be selling pizza cut with that very same pizza cutter, and he'll be selling it for the special price of $2 a piece, 3 for $6.
Wow, what a bargain!
Only here at the WrestlePlex.
And Concession Boy's starting to take over on Kubiak. People didn't think he was going to be able to do this. They knew he could come in and take a beating, but I don't think many people thought he could take it to Kubiak like he is. But the ultra-violent one is doing just that, and if Kubiak's not careful, he's going to lose his crown to this unheralded Concession Boy.
Concession Boy has done what very few have been able to do, and that's bust open the massively thick leather-like skull of Kubiak, who now has a crimson mask pouring down over his face. Concession Boy is somebody that is not known as a technical wizard. Handed another weapon by Lucius Sweet, which he busts. Is that a fork?
Shades of Abdul the Butcher right there on Kubiak's head. Concession Boy is impressing me. I know he's impressing you, Ronini. You love this stuff. And he's obviously impressing the fans at the WrestlePlex.
I am the hardcore giant, Ronini. And the one thing I appreciate is the blood, guts, and violence and DDTs by Concession Boy. He's not a technical wizard, but one thing this kid is tough. He's tough as nails, and he's not the smartest guy. If you've ever talked to this guy, the only thing he can talk about is fat chicks, fire, tax, and bloodbaths. He got everything so far, minus the fat chicks.
He sounds like a little Ronini, based on all that information you just gave us.
I don't like fat chicks. What are you talking about? And don't ever call me little. Where did you hear that from, Aaron?
I could just tell, Ronini.
I'm the human tripod, for God's sake. Get it straight. Back to the match.
I tell you, the human tripod, once again, I must mention how ironic the human tripod not involved with the Big Johnsons.
Forget about it. I'm not even going to give that ridiculous company any plugs. I cut them off. Watch the buy rates of Tampa plummet. Enough of that. Concession Boy, once again, absolutely ripping at the skull of Kubiak. Star Stevens gets down there and he says,
hey, brother, how you doing? You look like you hurt a little bit over here.
That does sound like Star.
It does sound like him a lot. But Kubiak comes firing back with one of those pie tin pen gimmick deals that you find at the dollar store. But what the hell is that? Is that a big metal thing stuck with tacks and barbed wire, Aaron?
Yes, it is. This was Concession Boy's weapon that he brought into the ring. And right about now, he's got to be just a little bit sorry about that. That's a big board, like you said, wrapped in tape. It's got tacks and barbed wire and all kinds of obscene things sticking out of it. And right now, it was just sticking in Concession Boy's head. And he's got to be going, what did I bring that in here for, brother?
This reminds me of old school IPW hardcore. There you see salt dumped over the head of Concession Boy, who's got to be in extreme agony. Lucius Sweets is no help at ringside, and the crowd chants IPW. This is like old school IPW.
Yes, wait, it is, Ron.
Don't cut me off when I'm talking about the blood and gore that made this group famous. Now he's squirting him with, what is that?
More lemon juice right in the cut and the eyes of Concession Boy, and he stops for a little bit to take a drink of his own, but it made his mouth very, very sour, and he had to stop.
There's only one thing that's possibly more painful than lemon juice squirted into the eyes or into the open cuts of Concession Boy, and that would be if Kubiak pulled out the pulp of the papaya and grinded it to his forehead. And then
all right, let's not start talking about the papaya pulp. We do want to stay on television.
All right, Aaron, I don't want to get a censor.
Look, he's cooking something up.
Is he making a sweet omelet for Concession Boy? No, he's smashing him in the head, and he's selling it Baron von Raschke style, but comes back with a handful of salt himself. Mr. Saito would be proud, Aaron.
Mr. Fuji, that's the first guy I thought of. And I tell you, Kubiak was making fun of the gimmick of Concession Boy a little bit. He was saying, this is your brains in a match with Kubiak.
That is exactly what he said, and Star Stevens was quite impressed by that. He came back after the match, and it said it reminded him of the brutal mud match in Puerto Rico, where we had the one-man gang, Carlos Colon and Rip Oliver, tearing each other to shreds.
Once again, those participants have changed in that crazy mud match. Star Stevens, he's confused enough as it is without us constantly changing those participants. But here, Concession Boy, oh, what is that, Tabasco? More lemon juice? I'm not even sure, Ron, but it's very, very painful, whatever it is. And Kubiak is as much trouble as I've ever seen him inside that IPW ring.
I hate to make this point in case anybody hasn't got it clear at home. These very condiments and juices of sorts are usually used to do when you're doing the cooking, where maybe you're making a lemon meringue pie and your relatives are coming over. They're not used for being poured into open wounds. For God's sake, if they break out the paprika, I don't know what I'm gonna do, Aaron.
I was hoping you'd say you were out of here, then I could cheer for some paprika.
No paprika, no garnishment whatsoever. You're not gonna see these guys in there with scallops or au gratin potatoes. This is all business. You're only gonna see things that you would find at the concession stand of the WrestlePlex. Why lemon juice is there, I don't know. Some people like to take their sponge cake and have the lemon juice applied ever so.
Alright, and here comes Concession Boy trying to get the salt, but it's apparently all gone. So he throws it away and goes for another gimmick, but that gets Kubiak Todd to come and kick him right in his ample stomach.
Right into his ample stomach. The one thing that this kid forgot when he got that nice trip from Mexico is you actually have to lift when you take that sweet, sweet nectar.
Yes, you cannot drink it.
No, you can't. But the crowd of the WrestlePlex is in awe. Once again, we got the worst fans in the world sitting right for the hard cam, sitting there dumbfounded, very ugly.
They're in awe.
They are in awe. But if you look to the other side of the WrestlePlex, the packed house, they're going nuts. They're standing on their chairs.
Van Terminator coming up, possibly.
If he goes up to the top rope, does a backflip and flies across the ring and kicks a boat in death style, I don't know what to do.
Oh, kick by the monster right in the face while he's in the tree made of woeful things.
That is the tree of woe. And you see the holy... I can't say it here on IPW.
Here comes the IPW chants and various other chants that our crowd is famous for. They can't believe what they're seeing. And Kubiak has Concession Boy in a whole heap of a mess.
What is he setting him up for now? Hasn't he finished him enough with that wicked, wicked kick to the chair, leveling his face and destroying what's left of this poor sap's brain and turning... What has he got there? What? He's not gonna let...
Where those things came from.
Listen to the crowd. They know that's over 2,000 tacks, which Kubiak has promised he's gonna bring to the WrestlePlex. Lucius Sweets is beside himself. He don't know what to do. He offered $10 in food stamps to Kubiak to no avail.
I tell you what, I can tell you from personal experience, those tacks will hurt your tender, tender flesh. Oh, he can't be doing this. Concession Boy trying to block it, but to...
Oh, my God. That's gonna be it.